Good evening, everyone. It's been a while since my last video. I had enough time. The wife is out doing some canvassing right now for her campaign. So, and I just finished eating. Thanks all of you that have subscribed in the last while. Some of the ones that have subscribed in the beginning when it was just stuff. Now a little bit more directed content. Once again, we are at the PIMAX Dallara Dash at Indy. For any of you who have just joined recently and maybe have not watched some of my past videos, I joined December 17th. Wasn't actually on December 17th, a couple of days later when I registered. But always run the dash, and it just happened that PIMAX was having a giveaway. So I had seen that, registered for it, so I thought I'd read into it a little bit more, and after a few days of racing, I found out that this was also the part of the grand prize, which was not this wheel, the RS wheel, D-shape, Alcantara, the R16 wheelbase, the digital dash, and the CRP pedals. And I was like, WTF, I gotta do something with this. And I started racing as much as I could and working. And then I ended up getting the virus around Christmas time and got quarantined for 20 days because I don't have the vaccine. I can't get it. I have a blood disorder that if I get it, then it's caused me a hemorrhage, so we skip that. So I ended up getting it and fought it off, and during that 20 days, I had nothing else to do but race the Dallara Dash, and 526 wins out of 876 starts, and I raced every race like I was losing. So, but they haven't done it again. So that time, the PIMAX AKX headset was the main part of it, which PIMAX still sponsors this. And MOZA was there also in addition to that. Now, hopefully there'll be some stuff coming down the pipe soon about what's going on. Hope to be able to announce that for you. If you stay tuned to my channel, you'll be able to find out what's going on as quickly as I'm allowed. So I do moderate the MOZA global community page on Facebook, and I'll put the link down below. You can come join us there, you can say hi, and you can check out the product from there because they're always doing their release stuff from there. And also I looked on Twitter, they got a picture of my race rig that I have here, which is the R-seat P1 from Europe. They build them in Sofia, Bulgaria, and because Canada has a trade agreement with them, anything that comes from the EU is duty-free. There's no putting tariffs on their stuff, so there's no taxes when I come in, just regular GST, PST, but anything else, no, because they're so that was pretty cool. And my buddy said if I won the Dallara Dash championship and won this stuff and the AKX headset, that he would get me the rig that I wanted. So I chose not to go with the extruded aluminum ones. I kind of like the pipe car looking thing. I don't plan on putting any motion on it or whatever. Let's get this qualifying done so we don't lose ourselves here. And hopefully I can remember where we left off and get back to it. So we used to do this track, and you could actually go out off the corner and sweep out to the track and then come back in on the apron again, or the run out lane. But you do that now and you get a black flag for some reason. Change that. Rob's at a 212, just blistering it. Time off our best there, 179, so we're already that territory now. Yeah, well off. Probably second place though. At third. Rob Logan's got a first. That's a pretty fast time. I mean, it might have been fifth gear because I stay in sixth. So next time around, we'll try the cone. We'll try fifth. Yeah, so after receiving this and being in touch with MOZA, they offered me the moderator position on the MOZA Global Community Facebook, and hopefully we can keep it a lot cleaner than what the other wheel is. Yeah, people say they're happy, so we want to keep it that way. Hey Rob, good lap, buddy. That's nice. So if you, just for giggles, if you go in and go to their website, MOZA's website, and price out the RS wheel, R16, digital dash, and the CRP pedals, and then go to PIMAX and price out their headset, and you'll see which one was the better of the grand prize. Unfortunately, PIMAX, sorry. But yeah, as you can see, I'm running three screens on the headset. I don't think you... It's really good to run a headset and do video stuff at the same time. So I don't know much about the MOZA stuff as far as operating it. I just kind of click shit. I'm no professional when it comes to direct drive steering wheel stuff. But I'll tell you, from where I came from to this, is like, I don't know, the Wright brothers to Elon Starship kind of thing. Yeah, I can actually catch the car, feel stuff. Totally different driving experience, and it's so smooth. The R16 is just so smooth. A lot of people have the R9. I guess it's a price factor plus a popularity thing. I'm not sure if it's. I guess money would factor into it. But really, for the extra few bucks that you would have to spend, I would just wait and myself and get the R16. And if you want to get a lot of feedback into the wheel without putting that much power into the wheel, then the R21 would be the way to go. If you're a serious sim racer, if you're just a hobbyist, then the R9 is all you need. wife's out doing canvassing tonight, door knocking for her election run October 15th. Looking forward to that. See how she does. Be popular right now. We're getting ready to go green. Yeah, just a tad, eh? Thank you. It's like only the first or second one this week. Sorry, no talking. Too busy racing. I want to thank everybody that has joined me. And I really do like this setup. I said that enough. Yeah, really nice stuff. Wheel's got a lot of strength to it. Just the grips, I guess something could be done as far as the... There's a little bit of a creaking sound there. Than that, the actual rigidity of the wheel is really good. Let's go back and take a look at that pass through wide there. Last race I did, I just kind of let people go by, and I did the same thing here, because I think as long as you stay in the graph, so this is Jan, he's from Scandinavia, and Rob, I'm not sure, this Rob is a state somewhere. But he's pretty good though. Oh, sorry, that wasn't the end. There's the end there. Who's that? That was William, I guess. Yeah, William. Sorry, William. I should know Jan's got the flame car. And we'll take a look at my car after a good friend of mine, Rex. Oh yeah, that lap car is just like parked there. Crazy stuff. Yeah, Rex did this car for me a long time ago when we used to have the Cora, which was a championship online racing association. That was years ago. And this is the car that I used to run. And I'll take a look at the paint after. Or maybe we'll roll through and see. Camera? Yeah. There you go. Not a bad camera view either. That's the gunfighter. Now we'll be able to get a good view of what goes on behind us here. I think Jan gets up beside him there, and Rob tries to shut the door, but Jan's already there. Oh, yeah. Jan was already on the top side there. Oh, and he's up into the stands. We gotta go look at that again. He's up into the stands. You can see that Rob is here and Jan has already moved to the outside there. So you'll catch more of a view of it when I cut back up there. Because I got tons of room behind me. So there we go. And there's Rob. And there's Jan. And you get up behind him. Jan is still against the wall. There. Still against the wall. See that. Still against the wall, and Rob comes up. Yeah. That was the three's fault. Pow! Look at that. Right up into the catch fence. Should, like, sparks should fly off of that. Oh, he's into the catch fence. And just flipping. let's get back on that. Does he make it? Oh, he's stuck in the catch fence. Oh. Yeah, at least there was no, none of the fans were, nobody was harmed in the making of this video. that was good. All right, well, just thought a little short video. Come say hi to everybody. If you're enjoying what I'm doing, then you can like, subscribe. We'll be doing some more stuff once my camera gets in. I plan on showing around my city, doing some virtual tourism. And nothing yet for as far as this stuff. It's fantastic. No complaints, no issues. Constant firmware updates, excellent service from MOZA themselves. I don't see why anybody wouldn't buy their product if they're looking for a change or looking for something better. And as you can see, I've tidied up some of my wiring at the back. I've mentioned that before. Bought some, like, a neoprene material with a Velcro both sides, and you can just take your cables and put them in and wrap them around and secure the Velcro on the other side. And then it comes with also a bunch of these Velcro zip tie kind of things. There's a bunch of layers of them, different colors, so whatever you choose. And you just wrap those around and they stick to themselves, as you can see. And those are used to gather any areas. Now I got one cable here. I've got some more of it. I'm going to cut a section for here. There'll be another tie-in off that. So it's coming together. As I always say, if you like it, do it. And when I have more stuff, we'll catch you in the next one.